Hello to my project on possibility management and getting to know some specific terms out of this game world. And today I have with me Anne-Chloé, and if I got that right, you're still in Vietnam.
Yes.
Yeah. And I invited you to talk about responsibility, radical responsibility. And right away, when I heard that term, I was thinking of how we would phrase it in German, and that I definitely feel a difference in Verantwortung, responsibility, and Eigenverantwortung, self-responsibility. And what I got out of the work is that it's really about self-responsibility. So radical responsibility for me, because I can use it as a bypass to say, oh, I'm going to take responsibility for others. And then I just don't take responsibility for myself.
Wow, I never thought of that. I mean, I spent some time in Germany. My first trainings were actually in German language, and I had translation. And I never heard this difference about these two words of responsibility and self-responsibility. And responsibility is really interesting to me. So I'm really glad that you asked me about it, because my relationship to responsibility is this thing called context. And it's a term that is not really often used, definitely not used in ordinary language or really in modern culture. And it is often really hard. It takes a while for people to grasp what this context, we keep talking about context and possibility management, what is that? And in a very, you know, definition, context is what is the relationship, what is our relationship to responsibility? So it could be my context, you know, what is my relationship to responsibility? But it can also be a group of people. What is the group of people's relationship to responsibility? It can also be a space, an energetic space. You know, what is the level of, what is our relationship to responsibility in this space? Or it can be in a game world, which is a project. For example, possibility management is a game world. So, and I won't really go into what a game world is. I could maybe make another video about that, because
that's
really
what
awesome.
I want to do.
Okay. But, and so then there's this question of, okay, there's such a thing as responsibility, and there's such a thing as my relationship to responsibility. And what is this? What is responsibility? And what we discovered is that there's this spectrum. And so there's a spectrum between zero level responsibility, which is basically, you can imagine the people who are in prison or who are in psychiatric clinics or something like that. They don't get to decide anything. They don't get to decide how they dress, what they eat, when they go out, who are their neighbors, where they're going. They decide nothing. So they are in their context is a zero level responsibility. They have no responsibility. And then the spectrum goes, okay, there's this child level responsibility. So, and really quickly, child level responsibility is a child can make a mess and not clean it up because the adults will clean it up. Okay, well, that's another level of responsibility, adult level responsibility. Okay, and then we're discovering, okay, there's also a higher level of responsibility, which is called high level responsibility. And even after that, there's this thing called radical level responsibility. And I just want to start by saying that even considering that there's such a thing as adult responsibility, which maybe if I understood what you were saying, is a form of self-responsibility. So an adult responsibility is I make action or I make inaction and they have consequences and I'm responsible for the consequences of my action or inaction, what I say, what I don't say, what I'm thinking, what I'm not thinking, how I'm moving, how I'm not moving. And so adult responsibility is fair. There's this fairness of I'm responsible for me. I'm responsible maybe for my family, for my house, you know, for paying my bills. So okay, that's adult responsibility, but other people have responsibility. Like my partner have she has her responsibility, and my brothers have responsibility, and there's difference, and it's fair. So what is them is theirs, and I don't have anything to do with it, but what is mine. And already that is incredible. Actually, already considering that there's such a thing as adult level responsibility is at the edge of what we call modern culture. Because modern culture, what we've learned, and it's a very clear example in school, for example, but also with our parents, is what we've learned is avoid responsibility at any cost. You make a mess, try to avoid responsibility for the mess you've made. So it's you're playing with your brothers and sister, and somebody, you know, breaks a lamp in the house, and your dad comes and says, you know, who broke the lamp? It's like, not me. It was them. You know, and we learn this. It is so instinctive that to win, to succeed in life, to succeed, the success is as much as you can avoid responsibility, you can succeed. And so we see that, you know, at the level of corporation, is that if they can avoid paying taxes, if they can avoid being responsible for toxic waste, if they can be, you know, avoid the responsibility of healthy or well taken care of employees, they will do it, because that allows them to make a profit. And that's success. If they can make a profit, they're succeeding. And so then there's this whole culture that is completely centered on child level responsibility. And so that's, it is crucial in terms of discovering what else is possible than modern culture, to have this conversation of there are different levels of responsibility. And what does somebody mean? What do you mean when you say responsibility? Do you mean zero level? Do you mean child level? Do you mean adult level when it's fair? Okay, or do you mean high level responsibility? Or do you even mean radical responsibility?
Yeah, and I was actually thinking of, I could take full responsibility for the waste around here,
mm-hmm.
and still bypass taking self-responsibility for my behavior, for my interaction with people, and for my emotions. Yeah, like,
mm-hmm.
I'm being driven by my feelings, by my emotions. I won't take any responsibility for that, but I will take responsibility to clean up the waste around.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a different approach, I guess. And that's what I was thinking about, because I'm in my story, in my history, I did well taking responsibility for other things, but not really for my growth, for my becoming mm-hmm. an adult.
Thank you for bringing that up, because then it opens this door to this conversation of, were you really taking responsibility? Was it actually responsibility, or was it your survival strategy playing out as, I'm a good girl, for example, I'm a good girl, and so therefore I learn to clean up other people's messes so that there's no conflict. So that, or I have a survival strategy of being the hero, you know, being the sacrificial hero. So I'm gonna work hard and burn myself out and take care of everything because I'm the hero. And at the end, you will all see that I, you know, I did it and you did nothing. Or, you know, quote unquote, taking responsibility for other people not feeling anything. So being completely adaptive, being completely pleasant and polite and fake and nice, so that there's this environment of whatever numbness or fakeness of no conflict, and then pretending that that's taking responsibility. And really, these are just survival strategies that are, they're painted, you know, they're painted with the mask of responsibility. And actually, we call them, it's being a responsible victim. You're not actually doing it because your point of origin has moved into, like, your point of origin is, where does your action emerge out of? Like, where are your action, your thoughts, your feelings, where is your life emerging out of? That's the point of origin. And a survival, if your point of origin is still in the survival behavior, you know, what you've learned in your childhood mostly, but not only, but what you, how you've learned to behave to survive. You know, what's the familiar patterns that if I do this, if I behave like this, then I know I can survive. I can control, manipulate my environment. Okay, that's a survival strategy. That is not taking responsibility. So it's being this responsible victim where you do it so that you can survive. And it's a complete shift of identity. I mean, I think this is what you were trying to say about this self-responsibility. It's a shift of identity, it's a shift of point of origin, and a shift of relationship to the world to move along this spectrum of responsibility. And that's what we call growing up. You know, when we say, we have this website, Grow Up Now, or we say those are initiation into adulthood. This is what we mean is moving your point of origin along the spectrum of responsibility as a new, let me see how to say this. There is an ecstasy in responsibility. There's a thrill, there's excitement. But we live on this, we've grown up, you know, we were raised with this old map of responsibility where if I'm responsible, it's a burden, you know, it's heavy, or I'm guilty, you know, it's my fault. If I'm responsible, it's my fault. I did it wrong. I didn't, you know, I could have done it better. If I'm responsible, it's also maybe, I will get rewarded. You know, if I'm responsible, then, you know, look at me, I did it, you know, I did it right. Okay, this is this old map. It's a survival map of relationship to responsibility. And we've been discovering, and a lot of people have done experiment with that. And people who come and meet possibility management are so excited to discover, oh yes, there is a new map of responsibility where I'm at source. I get to decide, I get to choose, I get to transform. I get to initiate. I get to be at cause. I get to cause things to happen, not for any reward or for any, you know, praising or criticizing, not because, but simply for the joy of sourcing, and also being able to be with other people who are sourcing, and then having this collaboration possible. It's possible collaboration.
I get a picture when you talk, like when I'm just a robot and I just act as I was trained and educated, and I take responsibility for stuff, or I become a mother and I take responsibility for my children, or I become a boss and I take responsibility for my employees, or I grow up and I will take responsibility for my elderly people or parents. And so I'm empty. The source, I'm not connected to the source, to the point of origin. I'm empty and I'm just like a robot doing that because I have learned to do it. And then I start to realize that and slowly fill up my vessel with something. Yeah. So I fill up myself with what's coming from the source, from the origin. Fill me up step by step. And then I may do the same thing. I may take care of my children or my old parents or my employees, but not as an empty vessel, but as a filled vessel. And then what's coming out, because it's filled and it's flowing over, then I have this new way of responsibility and really have the experience of, I am the source of what I'm doing. Does that resonate?
Yes, I will go one step further, because what it seems like you're talking about is that this filling this vessel is connecting to what we call your inner resources. So your center, you know, what do I want? What do I not want? How do I want it? What is, so this is also your feelings, you know, your anger, your sadness, your fear, your joy that informs you what is important, what matters, what needs to be changed. You know, the your four feelings, anger, sadness, fear, or joy, is your compass to decide how to move as feelings. So these are your inner resources, and you also have an energetic body where you have a sense of, you know, space or ownership or speed or direction. You have a physical body. You can take responsibility for the information of your physical body, also your intellectual body, your imagination, your intuition. So these are all your inner resources. And as you take responsibility for that, these are your compass, your tools, your, it's like your navigation board of saying, you know, where do I want to go with all this? So when you get access to your navigational board, you can start to navigate from here, not to complete a fantasy world, or not to complete some kind of image of, I have to be a good daughter or a good caretaker or a good mother or whatever belief system or fantasy world that you receive, you know, from some kind of, you know, education. Okay, so that's one thing, connecting with your inner resources. When you have access to your inner resources, what shows up is that you can have access to what we call the outer resources. And these are forces of the universe. We call them archetypal forces, such as Gaia. You can have access to Gaia and be, you can take responsibility, for example, for being a mouthpiece. You know what I mean? Mouthpiece. You can speak the words of Gaia, because she doesn't have a mouth. She can't speak except really for human beings with a language. Okay, well, you can take responsibility for being the mouth of Gaia. You can also take responsibility for being the space through which your bright principles. So these are pretty straightforward. You know, to some degree or another, we've all had that kind of experience of what bright principles are. What bright principles, what we call is these facets of love, or these facets of consciousness, or facets of responsibility, which is basically all the same thing. So it clarity, possibility, transformation, empowerment, community, family, resilience. So, you know, the 99 names of gods. Of God, your 99 names of God. And each of us is born with a set of bright principles that we serve. So we have a particular affinity for some of them. So, for example, my bright principles are love, possibility, clarity, transformation, empowerment. And I can connect with other ones when it's needed, teamwork, community, family, whatever is needed in the space. But my particular shape of my being and who I am actually transcribe bright principles from these archetypal forces. They're bigger than me, but they can come through me. They can do their work through me. And so there's other forces such as Echo, the Earth Coincidence Control Office, or my archetypal lineage, which is also something different. But I don't want to, you know, submerge people with all these terms. These are just doors. But what I wanted to say is, when you get access to these outer resources, which are archetypal resources, you're moving really along the spectrum of responsibility in terms of, as you're serving something greater than yourself, if I can put it in these words, you're serving forces that are bigger than you. You're taking responsibility closer to high level responsibility or radical responsibility, because it needs that level of unfairness. It is unfair for you to, you know, you're in a space, you're in a conversation, you're in a group, you're navigating a team, you're navigating a project, and you have built enough clarity, we call it matrix, you have built enough consciousness in yourself that you can take responsibility for outer resources after you've taken responsibility for your inner resources.
Yeah.
Most people in the room have not done that work.
Yes.
And so therefore you can't ask them to take responsibility either for their inner resources or outer resources when you can. However, what is interesting to me is I make spaces where the whole purpose and the whole point is for people to move along this spectrum of responsibility, where they can learn, God, I have feelings, God, I have a center, but I have my imagination is mine, my intuition is mine. I have belief system, I have fantasy world, I have survival strategy. I can also take responsibility for those and make a gap and be, I have survival strategy, I'm not my survival strategy. Let me discover what else I can create. And so, and for me, those are the most exciting spaces where taking responsibility becomes the central point of the ecstasy of being a human being.
So it's like training to inhabit my bodies, to create agency out of that center.
That is beautifully said. Yeah.
Okay. Exactly. Wow. Wow, mm-hmm. Thank you. Okay. For that topic, for that issue of radical responsibility, I want to leave it at that point.
Okay. Thank you very much. I just want to say we barely even, scratched the surface of radical responsibility. And we're talking about the spectrum. And so if we get to meet again and talk about, what is it like? What is it? I just want to say this thing to sort of wrap this up is, it is inconceivable for most of us to engage radical responsibility, or to think about it, to imagine it. And at the same time, when I met this work, that the fact that that was a possibility, just even if I couldn't engage with it, or I didn't understand what it meant, or who I would have to become to enter that possibility, that field, that context, was the doorway that got me in. So, yeah, thank you.
Okay, thank you too. Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye-bye.